Ekeke is the founder and producer of Miss Nigeria International, based in Minneapolis, Minnesota, USA. I'm originally from Abia State in Nigeria. I came to the United States in 2009. I've been living in Minnesota. I went to school in New York, in Syracuse University, and I studied communications at the Newhouse School of Public Communication. And then I've moved back to Minnesota, and since then, I really have no regrets living in Minnesota, because there's a lot of healing potential that, you know, people need to really tap into in the state. A lot of people ask me before, why are you in Minnesota, of all the states in the U.S.? And now I see the reason why I could never leave. I tried to leave a number of times, but something always got me back, and, you know, I'm glad that I stayed, and I have no regrets. Aside from the Miss Nigeria International, I'm also a health IT professional. I came from the world of pageants. I was privileged to be the first Miss Commonwealth Nigeria 2002, and I represented Nigeria and Miss Earth in the Philippines also in 2002. So ever since then, I've always wanted to give back to the industry that, you know, brought me to the limelight. So since living in the U.S., I've always contemplated starting a pageant, and eventually the vision was born in 2015, and eventually we had the very first Miss Nigeria International in 2018. So the next 2 months or 2.5 months, we'll be having the second edition of the Miss Nigeria International as well, and it's been so far so good. The first edition, from the feedback that we got to people who attended, it was very good. For the first time, we had close to 350 people in attendance, which is way beyond expectations of people who just started any project. So this year, we're anticipating to double that attendance. So it was really good for the very first time, and we're, you know, hoping to do better than we did last year. The second edition of the Miss Nigeria International will be coming up in Minnesota October 26th at the Fridley High School in Fridley, Minnesota. Yeah, people should expect to see a lot of diversity in attendance. There will be a parade of fashion, there will be a showcase of talent, there will be a lot of artists performing, and there will be, the audience should expect to see like a belly dancer, R&B, hip-hop dancer. There will be a lot of eloquent speeches from our guest speakers. There will also be like artist performers, people who play instrumental. So there will be a diversity of talent display on stage. So audience should expect to see that, and then there will be a lot of mixing and networking, and a lot of collaboration will be going on while the show is on. And of course, plenty of food. There'll be a lot of finger food that will be served so people can keep their bellies while they watch. So it's going to be a very good, fun time. Last year, we had support from certain individuals, even small business owners, mid-sized business owners, not just from the Nigerian community. We had support from the Togolese community, Liberian community, Cameroonian community, Ethiopian community, I think also Ghanaian community as well, and Kenya as well. So there's a lot of, you know, support from the African community in Minnesota. So we're very thankful for that.
Now, what is the focus of Miss Nigeria International?
The whole objective of the Miss Nigeria International is to be able to advance the global cause of the young Nigerian woman living in the diaspora, and to also help them build their confidence, to advance their creativity, to become entrepreneurs, and also to engage themselves. So every of our queens, they have a platform that they work with. Our present queen is into mentorship, school mentorship, and to help, you know, to alleviate the number of black kids that are taken out of the school system and putting alternative pathways to school. So that is what she's really advocating for. And by the time they're done, you know, with the whole pageant system, I find that these girls, you know, have really reinvented themselves. Some of them discover, you know, all that hidden potential they didn't even have within them. Their confidence is boosted. You find them more active in the community. They're engaged in community service. Some of them, you know, like one of them who competed last year, she didn't even make top 7, but she's coming back this year. as a performer, as a dancer. So these girls discover hidden talent and they become best athletes of the society overall. At the Miss Ebony, I think her performance was excellent. It was very good. She was outstanding. Well, I probably, I would say, the most eloquent out of all the contestants. So she was outstanding in her performance at the Miss Ebony.
Are you planning to give back to Nigeria?
Yeah, I'm already giving back to my immediate community where I come from in Eastern Nigeria, and I hope to do more with the larger Nigerian society to also benefit from some of the things that we have been privileged to have.
Fascinating Nigeria.